I used to feel sorry for these guys, and a lot of people are impacted by this. The short sellers are making decisions on behalf of retail investors. That means mum and dad investors have lost hundreds of millions, in fact, possibly even billions of dollars as a result of bad decisions by fund managers. But I don't feel sorry for them anymore. If you park your money with someone who's an idiot, well, I guess really it's your own fault. This year, short sellers have lost $12.2 billion. If they hadn't learned their lesson over the past 5 years, it seems they still aren't going to learn. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the channel. I'm Sam Evans. You're watching The Electric Viking. It's a true story. Short sellers have lost $12.2 billion in 2023. Following a better year, and for them in 2022, when they said, "We told you so, look at this." Well, short sellers have now lost an insane amount of money. In fact, Tesla short sellers watched their bets against the electric car manufacturer basically implode to $12.2 billion in losses. The reason for this, Tesla stock more than doubled in value over the course of 2023. Short sellers had a shocking year, though, in general across the US share market. I don't understand the point of being a short seller. I think it's like you're just saying, you know what, I'm smarter than everyone else, and I'm going to go and short sell Tesla, and then you look like an absolute moron. So you're taking a pretty big risk here. Now, realistically, even though Tesla's short sellers have lost so much money over the last 5 years, Tesla is still the most shorted stock in the world. Incredible, but it's actually true. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, well, hang on a minute, short sellers did really well in 2022. They made apparently $15 billion, which means they're up. Well, yes and no, because if you track the stock market for the past 2 years, if you did what Warren Buffett tells you to do, and Warren Buffett says this, if you don't know what to do with your money, just invest it in the index. Literally, just find an index, invest it in that. Well, almost any index in the NASDAQ, for example, the NASDAQ or any other stock exchange around the world has done better than what short sellers have done over the past 2 years shorting Tesla. But if you look at the, say, 4 or 5 year history of these shorts, shorting Tesla, they've lost many, 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 many billions of dollars. I mean, the number is just insane. In fact, in 2023, shorts losses across the entire stock exchange were astronomical. They lost $195 billion in 2023. Despite winning on regional banks, they lost $12.2 billion on Tesla, $11.2 billion on Nvidia. On Apple, they lost $7.3 billion. On Meta platforms, Facebook. How do you lose money on Facebook? Shorting Facebook, I don't know. But anyway, they lost $6.6 billion. Microsoft, $5.6 billion. Amazon, $5 billion, Coinbase, $4.2 billion, Broadcom, $3.3 billion, AMD, $3.2 billion, and Palo Alto Network, $3.1 billion. I mean, who's Palo Alto Network? That's a weird one. Anyhow, if you want to know how much short sellers have lost, here is the number. It's actually been revealed since 2010, between 2010 to now. So over that 13-year period, the majority of the short action and majority of the losses have come over the last 5 years. But the total losses are $61.8 billion. Now, that's more than the GDP of half the world's countries. In fact, more than half. Those numbers are just absolutely insane. Here's what Dan Ives from Wedbush Securities said. Every year, the bears come out of hibernation mode and think, this is the year that Tesla shares collapse. The bears view it as an automobile company that should trade at a valuation a multiple of General Motors or Toyota. The bulls, such as myself, believe it's a disruptive technology company. And that's the Wall Street consensus view. Which side are you? Do you agree with Dan Ives or the consensus? Or do you believe, do you side with the shorts? Do you think that, Tesla's just a car company. It should be valued like that. So it's probably overvalued by about 90% based on that valuation. What are your thoughts on this one? Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.